Okay, I am so sorry. I overslept today. And first of all, hello, good morning, and welcome to Chapter 8 of Quidditch, the first house match. Now, if I'm going to warn right now, there are going to be very ugly uniforms that might burn your retinas. Yeah, just go with it, okay? I have ugly uniforms. I'm not even going to send emails about it anymore because I've been doing it for like 2 months, nothing. So I've lost hope. Jesse will not fix the texture glitch. If you guys have a texture glitch, you're doomed. But I have decided that I'm not going to let the texture glitch ruin the fun of Quidditch. So it's time for our first house match. Also, I overslept today. Okay, ji, prepare for house match. Come on, don't keep me waiting too long. Come on! Why are there bugs in my room in the... It's not even light in the... Yes! Ugly uniforms, don't. Just don't question it. Don't. I'm not using the mouse pad. Mouse pad is getting in my way. This is a seeker actually. Do you hear the crowd? Sounds like all of Hogwarts is here. That's the keeper. I need more broom wax. Who's got broom wax? Oh, I have broom wax in my back pocket. I am not even joking. I'm pretty sure FZ has broom wax in her back pocket. She is one of the... No, she is the beater. Someone said Rath is in the stands. Is she? She's a student, obviously. Don't question. I'm going to say this again the last time. Don't question the uniforms. Don't question the trousers, that is. There you are. We were just talking about you. Why? What did I do? Huh? All good things, I hope. Oh shit. I turned off the keyboard controls, didn't I? Of course. At least 99.3% I was quite positive. Wait, what's the other 0.7%? What was the other 0.7% about? Margin of error. Oh, that actually makes plenty of sense. Whatever that means. Listen, there's always little room for improvement.
Yeah.
But at what point does one run out of room? Orient, can you not do the cryptic questioning now? You told me to pick a move, if you've forgotten. No time for mindbenders, Captain. For once, I agree with Sky. I mean, I'm pretty sure I agreed with Sky earlier also. I don't know. We've got our first British house match to go and win right now. So this is it. It's time right now. Look at FC's face. Scared as. Yes. How do you feel about holding the fate of our team in your hands? No. I am not prepared to make these big decisions in our first house match. This is not curse breaking. I was 23% convinced you would say that. The fact that you aren't ready is exactly why Orion put you in charge. That makes no sense.
Yeah.
I have no doubt that everything will work out as it should. Please stop. Now, my teammates, let us gather for a moment of vivification before we fly out onto the pitch. A moment of what? Moment of vivification? Pep talk. His Orionisms are supposed to be legendary. It's why I'm here. Okay, where the hell are the keyboard controls? Got it! Found the keyboard controls, and what the hell, 8 hours? What the hell is that? Go out on that pitch and make a Quidditch memory. Oh. I've got to use the loop. Dude, go! What are you waiting for? No moment of evocation in professional Quidditch leagues. I don't know if that's a good thing or a bad thing. And I thought I was a talker. And so begins up, whatever. Dude, you just like complete your moment of evocation. One team, three matches, one Quidditch Cup, that is maths. Huh? Dude, if math was that simple, I wouldn't need to skip it in school. Or in what? Hey, I'm not going to question it. I'm not going to question the captain. Who here has seen my broom bags? Dude, I have broom bags in my back pocket. Just take it. I've got to use it. Go! You're not going to go to the bathroom in the middle of the match. Go to the bathroom. Can a pep talk help me decide how to lead today's match? It's a stupid idea. I'm just going to stress that. This is the third time this girl has said, I want to use the loop. Go, man. Technically, Murphy is a Hufflepuff, so he's allowed to be in here, right? Oh my god, this is the fourth time, Seeker, go! How many times have I said go? Okay then.
Hey.
The time has come, my teammates.
Yeah.
Remember, for this match, we will take our cues from Sarahi once we take flight. Oh my god. I was hoping people would forget about that.
Hey.
Let us go to the Quidditch pitch and make Hufflepuff proud. Oh, I actually kind of expected this. Blimey, I've got to head to the commentary box. Have a brilliant match, everyone. Give me something to talk about. Actually, I've already decided I'm going to be using the Thimble Leg Shuffle. Yeah. Dazzle me with strategy. And I'm especially looking forward to watching what you'll do out there, Sarahi. Thank you, Murphy.
Uh-huh.
Well, here we go, Sarahi. We're all counting on you. Don't give me the pressure, please. I'll do my best not to let anyone down. You have got what it takes to do what it takes, Rahi Silvers. I'll try to remember that, Captain. What are you all waiting for? The first house match must begin now. Come on! And I'm of course... Okay, alright, it's decision time. I must choose what I will do on the pitch. I actually already decided the Thimble Leg Shuffle. At least in the last chapter, I decided on the Thimble Leg Shuffle. Because I don't like the fact that Murphy is known as just the wizard in the wheelchair. I didn't like that. Thimble Leg Shuffle, yeah. Thimble Leg Shuffle? Final decision? Thimble Leg Shuffle. I'll go with the Thimble Leg Shuffle when it matters most. I want to choose with my heart and do what I believe. And that's going with Murphy and the Thimble Leg Shuffle. Should we assume you're saving your speed for the match, Miss Silvers? Sorry, I'm coming, Madam Mooch. I'm ready to play in my first Quidditch house match. Please don't question my trousers. Now what? What the heck? Oh, that's what's supposed to happen. Hold up, wait a minute. Again. Everybody's got ugly trousers, so I don't have to feel too bad about it. Where's my... Will somebody explain to me where my armor is? Those are all NPCs. One thing. When we, have a magic history Ravenclaw. Will Andre be on the team? Because he was already on the team at this point of time. This is cool, by the way. This would make a good screenshot for a thumbnail. Definitely. That is like if you ignore the ugly trousers. Just please ignore the ugly trousers. I wonder if we'll ever have a Quidditch match in like the dark and the rain. Like, in which movie was it? Goblet of Fire? No, it wasn't Goblet of Fire. Which one was it? I don't remember. I think Prisoner of Azkaban. Yeah, Prisoner of Azkaban it was. I don't think we will ever have that kind of a match because Jam City is too lazy to like form weather. Kya, what? Jam City has not even fixed a texture glitch. You think they're going to make weather? Ha! Okay, don't keep me waiting. Come on, I wanna play! It's bad enough that I overslept today. Come on. Aha, finally. This is legit a house match now. And all the teachers behind McNally, that... By the way, our astronomy classes have still not started. When are those going to start? Welcome to the first Quidditch Cup match. Slytherin versus Hufflepuff. Put your pumpkin pasties down and hands together for the Slytherin team. What the hell? And now for the Hufflepuff team with two new chasers, Sky Parker and Sarahi Silvers. Dude, that does not need to be announced at every point of, you know what, I'm not even going to question it. Yes! This is awesome! And finally, our referee, Madam Mooch. Grab your binoculars and get ready for the first match of the year. Wait, what? Wait, it started already? What the hell? Silvers has the coffin and the Slytherin. Yeah, I usually play friendlies, but this is so much more pressure. And I'm not... Oh my god, why am I taking so much pressure? Okay, I stretched my hand. Silvers has the coffin and the Slytherin chaser in pursuit. We're off to an exciting start. Silver's got to pass the quaffle to Amari before the Slytherin chaser nabs it. Like, I don't care about a perfect match on this one. We just have to, like, win. Yes! I can't. There is no room for screwing up anymore. Silver's passed the quaffle to Amari, keeping it in Hufflepuff hands. Brilliant strategy. I haven't even done the actual strategy yet, too. Oh, face paint kid! Face spinny. Oh, there she is! You know, we have other Hufflepuff. Never mind. Hufflepuff has a great chance to win, but the Slytherin chaser got the quaffle. Looks like Silver's tagged to steal the quaffle. A successful theft will improve Hufflepuff's odds by 59%. Thank God! Can we get this match over with, please? Silver's nicked the quaffle from the Slytherin chaser like a nocturnally pickpocket. That is not a compliment. That is probably a compliment. Yes, Penny, I see you. Oh my God, I've been shouting a lot. Looks like Slytherin is catching on that Silvers is the one to watch out for the... Oh, dear God. Please, don't hit me with the bludger. The Slytherin chaser's got the quaffle and a part to the goalpost, but Silvers has other ideas. I read that the house matches are generally harder than the friendlies. Maybe it's because of the speed of the circles. And by the way, this crowd, na, is just people, It's like cardboard cutouts just being up and down. Other than that, it's nothing. Silvers will have to nudge the quaffle out of the chaser's hands or it's 10 points to Slytherin. Damn it, damn it, damn it, damn it, damn it! Okay, relax, relax. It is impossible to get a perfect match on this one. The fact that we are going to win is like awesome. Silver Snatch knocked the quaffle right into the Parkin's hands. The odds of that working were only 11%. What? Oh, Frieza Sprout seems happy. Thimbleick Shuffle. Looks like the players are showing signs of fatigue, but the match must go on. For how long? Silver's got the quaffle. After that last maneuver, this chaser's got a shot at the goalpost and victory. Silver's lining up to shoot a goal, but the Slytherin keeper won't be easy to beat. Yeah, are you sure about that? Yep, I'm sure. Oh, but that's okay. At least it was on the first arrow. Oh my god. Why am I so stressed over this one? I'm stressing myself out too much. The first house match could all come down to this next move, and looks like Silvers is setting up for something never seen in a house match. Let's call it a Thimbleick Shuffle. Dude, you... The Hufflepuff chasers have moved into formation. They've got the quaffle and great odds of keeping it. Okay, my hands are not even staying on the desk anymore. My hands can't even stay on the desk anymore. Clearly, this strategy is the work of a Quidditch genius. Watch closely. Oh no, don't screw it up. Don't screw this up. Don't screw this up. 8 seconds. Why do I keep getting 8 seconds? Yes. Dude, what are you looking at? That? I got the quaffle. Yes! The Hufflepuff chasers have turned a new strategy into a proven strategy. Thimbleick Shuffle. Remember it. Yes, do remember it. Yes! Did we win? And what's this now? The snitch has been caught. Hufflepuff wins their very first match, putting them in a good position to win the Quidditch Cup. Yes! I mean, it is a very terrible win because of the fact that how the meter has... like only inched out of the middle, but we won, man. Yes, 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 yes. Woohoo! I mean, then look at the meter. That is a pathetic meter, but you know what? I'll take it. Do you have any idea how hard that was? 8 seconds and... I need to grab a glass of water. That was so awesome. Ugh. Ugh. Successful match. Oh god. Ugh. I don't even care, man. What did we get? Anyway, whatever. Not that it's gonna make any difference. Oh my god. I need to stop and get a glass of water, man. Okay, I got a glass of water. I mean, I drank it already. Oh. I am exhausted. I'm not exhausted. I'm basically just tired of yelling so much. Okay, what do you think? Our house has got to be celebrating right now. Was Sky's dad watching the match? I heard he was here. Yeah. We're already on our way to the House Cup match. I think our final match will be against Ravenclaw. That was unbelievable. The crowd, the match, the win, all of it. Nothing else like it. So how do you feel after playing your first house match? Can we give these people names, please? I love Quidditch! I love Quidditch! Learning to play, making the team, and now this! It's just what I needed! Brilliant first match, Sarahi. Well done. Already you're a great addition to our team. Exciting times ahead for us. Can we please give this sweet these sweet people names? Thank you. I'm just happy we won this match for Hufflepuff. Professor Sprout told me herself that she wanted a win today. She was really happy. Everyone, gather around. Come on, just let us enjoy the win, Captain. But what are we without spirited team discourse, Sky Parkin? I know the answer. Winners! Can you give these people name, please? I gave the seeker a name, the name Fiona. Why? Because I could. I shall make it fast. But our rousing victory over House Slytherin deserves a few words. Orionism? Orionism. Just for 1 hour this time. Wow! That's a good angle, man. We still have other... but can we think about that later? Let's... 240 points ought to put us closer to the Quidditch Cup. Oh. I just realized, if I don't get... What do you call it? Celebrate now, practice later, focus always. Yeah. Like, I'm just thinking. Like, the meter did not go all the way up or up any... Up. It did not go very high while I was playing. If that happens... That happens repeatedly, you know, in the other matches as well. Will it not give... Will it come of the tide? We don't get enough points. Dude, just don't even. Okay, we won the match. That's all that matters. That makes no sense. As one team, we... Orion, you're great and all, but that makes no sense. Alright, it's done. I'm so relieved, man. I hope it's not like that. I hope it's just enough wins, not the... What do you call it? And so it has been a momentous day of Quidditch for all of us.
Yeah.
We have won together, guided by the decisions of Sarahi Silvers alone. But it wasn't my idea that I would be doing the deciding. 240 points to 110. Hufflepuffs come through with a big win.
Yeah.
Welcome, McNally. We were just in the middle of something. Uh-huh. Right, we were just in the middle of wrapping up. Huh. About time too, because Sarahi and I needed to have a little post-match chat. Oh, sheep. Is this about not doing the Park and Spencer? Or the inspired room surfing? It shall have to wait because I too need to speak with Sarahi. Sky call dibs. Get in the queue. Needing a chat with Sarahi is why I am here. So each of you need to talk to me right now. Suppose we can all chat together then. Let's head to the pitch. Why? Want to get my... Oh, come on! Only been recording for 5 minutes, man. I should have taken a break now. Okay, we're finally here. Can have a chat now. And yes, I'm pretty sure this is about the move thing. Like, what move did you pick? Oh! I got it! Not that it matters. Why are we still in our robes? And why did we come to the pitch for this? I'll say my piece first.
Yeah.
Should not the captain lead this chat? Ravish, I said I wanted to talk to Sarahi before either of you did. I'll speak first. Breaking the...
Whoa.
Oh, all right, let's hear it. Nobody questions the great MC. A twist, 99.7% unexpected. Carry on, Sarahi, we are listening. I've got a feeling you all want to talk to me about my decisions in the match. You should know I went with my heart when I decided which move I'd call when it mattered most. It was a personal choice to go with who made me most believe in their point of view. And that was Murphy. Where's the wheelchair? And we won, so it all worked out for the best. Why is his wheelchair up? You know what? 1 minute. Just give me a minute. The wheelchair isn't where it's supposed to be. You know what? Never mind. I restarted the game. It still did not make a difference. But you know what? I've got ugly trousers. Come on now. So you're saying each of us, knowing you'd be making the moves, tried to influence you before the match. Whether you tried to influence me, only each of you knows for sure. But you each asked to see me, shared a bit of something personal, and the move you favored did come up. McNally, Orion, shame on you. Yeah. McNally's off his... on us? You did the same thing.
Yeah.
I do not believe in shame. Of course you don't. Well-meaning or not, it sounded like we all did the same thing, Sky. Listen, I learned something new in talking with each of you, so it wasn't a bad thing. Everyone learns something new after talking with me. I'm full of valuable knowledge. That's why I wanted to chat. I had to say thanks for calling the Thimbleweed Shuffle. Whether you did it for me or not, getting to commentate on my own strategy in my first house match. Realizing all of Hogwarts will know the strategy by name. Realizing all of Hogwarts will see how brilliantly it works. Realizing all of that all at once, it's got me speechless. I'm glad you approve of my decision. I chose the Thimbleweed Shuffle because I believe in you, Murphy, and I knew it would mean a lot to you.
Hey.
And I'd say the Thimbleweed Shuffle had something to do with our house ultimately winning.
Yeah.
I should like to think inspired broom surfing would have led to far greater triumph. Actually, it wouldn't have, because I'm dumb. Thimbleweed Shuffle, good luck getting it to catch on. Now back and spin, sir. That move is a classic. Everyone, please don't fight. It was our first Quidditch house match. It wasn't my decision to make decisions. So we're in agreement that Orion made this happen. I don't think we're in agreement about anything. I am in agreement with myself and that is what matters. Oh my god, you people. Agreement with yourself? What does that even mean? You know he's going to answer the question of the questions, guy.
Yeah.
Have you statistics to support that, McNally? I should have known this would happen. I'm out. Bye-bye. Stop. Blimey, where did you come from? You know what? I'm shutting this down again. I cannot stand this wheelchair in the wrong place. Agreement with the... You know what? That wheelchair just won't come back. Never mind.
Yeah.
I should have known this would happen. Stop! Blimey, where did you come from? Facepaint Kid is a rather stealthy eavesdropper. I can eavesdrop on this conversation no longer. Think the rest of us planned on sticking around, but you can go, mate. But I'm Hufflepuff's biggest Quidditch fan. You have to hear me out. Alright, Facepaint Kid, let's hear it. Please, shut them up. A third party is needed. Yeah, now the wheelchair is back where it belongs. I wonder what all that face paint all the time does to someone's complexion. Actually, that is true. I suppose we can't win at the Quidditch Coffee Fair at all. Exactly! What aside your differences, if not for your team, for our house. Thank you. So wise. Focus on points, not wins and losses. The Quidditch Cup is at stake. Have you no idea how many of us want to be Quidditch players like you? Don't look at me. Look at them. Also, if any of you haven't taken my patented Quidditch course, you should. Dude, this is not a good time. Quidditch fans cheer on their houses, win or lose. It's points that matter the most. someone always has to intervene when MC's friends are fighting. MC, like, does not, like, have the ability to raise their voice or something. Remember that one time all of our friends were arguing in the library, it was Barnaby who raised his voice. Why doesn't MC do that? It's obviously necessary sometimes. So what I'm saying is, I don't put all of this paint on my face for nothing. I do it for you, I do it for Quidditch, and I'm not the only one. So please get along, you're heroes to our house and we need heroes. What about Quidditch commentators? Are we heroes too? Let us say that they are, McNally. See, you're getting along better already. Thank you, Facepaint Kid, for reminding us how Quidditch brought us together. And thanks for stopping these three, they're idiots sometimes. It had to be done right away. Quite the victory celebration going on in the Great Hall right now. Keep arguing and you'll miss out on all the fun. Thanks for the tip.
Yeah.
So shall we all go together to the Great Hall then? We shall, I suppose. I'm in! Let's go! Come on, time to have some fun! Oh, come on! Okay, we can go to the Great Hall now. I have no comment. What were we doing when we left off? I forgot. That being said, it's also Halloween. Where'd all the pumpkins go? Anyway, yep, that is quite the celebration. I told you that you'd want to stop by. That is quite the celebration. Wow. Look, our new chaser is here. Chasers. Congratulations, brilliant match. Is that a goldfinch? Lots of candy also I'm seeing. And mini hoops and very disappointed Slytherins. Anyway, let's just... like, yeah, I can see. That is so cute, man. Blimey, Facepaint Kid wasn't joking. Look at this brilliant turnout from our house. And look at the pride in our Hufflepuff Quidditch team. And look at how everyone's looking at the three of you like you're rock stars. You pretty much are, man. And look at how everyone's looking at me for arriving with rock stars. Dude. What? You're the commentator. And look at... Yes, Murphy, we can see it all. Support can be quiet or exuberant, but it is always powerful. What would have happened if we lost the match?
Uh-huh.
Right, I'm glad we all came here together. Let us go and celebrate our Quidditch win with our housemates. Okay. Oh, MC is always so... I just want to see MC doing the dribbling thing. Oh, that's adorable. Now, it's not dribbling, but I just like seeing MC do that. Sir, I look so happy. Okay. Aren't we all captains of the Quidditch team in spirit? Dude, stop answering questions with questions. Did my voice sound like a professional Quidditch commentator's voice? Did it? Yes, it did. Right, my dad was here, but he's already off to play his next match. Brilliant broom walk on the pitch today. Did I tell you about the time I saved our Quidditch team? It was today. I know everyone was counting on Parkin to score. Couldn't let you down. Can I get the new chaser's autograph? Hey, so the chaser thing brings me out on the map of popularity and the curse breaker thing didn't. I don't get it. I mean, not that I mind, because I don't like a lot of attention. I'll never forget my first house match. Try by the commentary box. I'll show you my playbooks. So the curse breaker thing does not make people admire me, but Quidditch does. I don't get it. What's the logic? Not that I mind. I'm just saying. Yeah, you totally can. This was adorable, man. Really. Chatting with our house's Quidditch fans has got me excited all over again about the match. So are you saying if you had to play all over again, you choose the same move in the match? Yeah, actually, I'd made the same choice. Yes, I'd make the same choice. We won after all. And think of all the points we scored. Points are what matter if you have to win the Quidditch Cup. This time we won. We got lucky. Let us not escalate the discord here. Remember, this is a Hufflepuff celebration. She's smiling. Okay, that smile turned menacing, but it's a smile anyway. Look who just crashed our party. It's the Great Hall, man. They can come here. Erika Raj again. She and her mates passed by me at the pre-match party. And then what happened? Raj stopped and looked at me, then just walked away. People are saying that it is possible that Erika is mute. I'm not sure. Nobody is. She has not said a single word as of yet. But maybe that's just because we haven't talked to her yet. I don't know. What? Raj can't do that. Dude, she's literally looking at us right now. Look behind you, Sky. She can. She's literally doing that right now. And she and her Ravenclaw Quidditch mates can't just sit over there and ignore us. Dude, she's literally staring at us. She's staring right at us into our souls. They are. What are you so bloody excited about, McNally? A relevant, riveting rivalry to talk about. Ravenclaw is the team to beat this year. Indeed, Rath and her mates are playing mind games. Dude, they literally. Then let's win. Let's put my decisions today, whether you like them or not, behind us. Let's be united front. Literally, they are literally just sitting over there. How is that a problem? They are literally just sitting on their butts. I conquer. Uh-huh. Right, I'm in too. I'm not even on the team and I'm in. What's next?
Uh-huh.
Practice, of course. Right now? It is a wise solution. Rath cannot play mind games with us if we are not here. Did Orion just call me wise? This united front idea of yours might just work out after all, Srahi. Let's head to the pitch. She is literally just sitting on a chair. And don't make me... Orion! Yeah, okay, we do need rest. How many tasks are left for this one? Oh, good, this is the last task, okay. Okay, practice time. Why do I still have Great Hall sounds? Okay, the Great Hall sounds stopped. Again with the ugly uniform. You know what? Screw you. Rath and her mates said, what in the Great Hall? They're literally just sitting on their butts. How is that a bad thing? Practice makes perfect. Let's see. Am I the only one still tired out after our first match? No, dude, even I'm tired. I'm hungry too.
Yeah.
What was that sound? What the hell was that sound? Let us begin practice, my teammates.
Uh-huh.
Right, we've got a ravishing, riddling rivalry brewing. A what? Mm-hmm. Isn't that what McNally called it, Sarahi? A relevant, riveting rivalry, he called it, with Erika Rath and the Ravenclaws.
Uh-huh.
Right, what's Rahi said? Let's play Quidditch! Are you gonna make me play? No, I'm literally just doing it right now, okay. Yeah, screw the ugly uniform. I'm just gonna make a new save and see what happens. And I don't have time for a new save right now. I don't exactly have time to make a new save right now. Yes, we know, we know. Now this is just like the legit boring stuff. Yes, that Timberlake shuffle is now a real thing. See, the circles are so much slower now than they were in the match. And there is no timer. I still never got a perfect match though. I got the coffee, man. Wrong person. The lights just turned off in my room. Why are the lights off? Why are the lights off? Oh, they're back on. Yep. Yes, yes, the fine line between a bump and a foul. We know. Why am I never wearing knee pads? Explain. Holy crap, that was a timer! I didn't even notice, man. Huh. Oh, another event. Oh, 10 seconds. Like, we got 8 seconds in the match. And the circles are moving a lot faster. Yes, we know. I'm awesome. Now that was a good match. Look at how much the meter filled. That the house match was only like filled till here. Smashing practice, Sarahi. I'm pretty sure MC is tired now. Thanks, but I think I've got a splinter. Ouch. I've never gotten a splinter in my life, to be honest. Ouch, that's rotten. Time to trade in this wretched shooting star room you've been borrowing from Hooja's stash. Trade it in for what? A different wretched shooting star? I'm just telling you what you're riding is in the room of a Quidditch champion at all. I should go and see Madame Pomfrey about the splinter. This is what MC looks like in the thinking face without the finger. Sorry. Gather around my teammates, I have one last announcement before we depart the pitch.
Yeah.
I have learned who we shall be playing in that second house match. Gryffindor? Smashing, tell us, Captain.
Yeah.
First, let me tell you about our opponents. Don't make the enemy the... It's Gryffindor, isn't it? Again an Orionism? Dude, it's Gryffindor! I've got to use a loop. Go! What the hell is in this girl in bathroom? Orion's clues are never helpful. All I can think about right now is finding a pair of tweezers. Why? Oh, for the splinter! Dude, could just go to the bathroom. MC just watched Wizard. I've never actually gotten a splinter in my life. Are they really that painful? Well, I suppose they are. Yeah, I just need to go to the to Madame Pomfrey. So, Orion, can you hurry up your Orionism? Thank you.
Yeah.
And so the house he shall play next is?
Yeah.
Gryffindor! Come on! See? I knew it! xoxo. They're fastest on the broom. They're fastest on the brooms this year. Yeah, I'm going to be the next house match will be against Claralyn. Yeah. And if I ever beat her, I would have knocked her off the broom. It was a story she wrote. Don't ask me. How do you know? McNally can't help but spout his scouting reports at me every time I fly by his box. Even coming off a big win in our first house match, we'll have our work cut out for us. So what do we do now? How do we prepare?
Whoa.
For you, answer's easy. You're going to need a better broom. Challenge accepted. So that's it. Okay. I'm gonna do two friendlies and then what? Okay, I'm gonna stop. But I think actually that last after these two friendlies, the chapter is over. So this is pretty much the end of the chapter, at least the story part. Come on, you don't want to see me do friendlies now. Yeah, so this is the chapter, Quidditch chapter. I don't know when we are going to get the Kiara side quest. I thought that's what we'll get today. But because of the fact that we didn't, I overslept. And now I have to do a lot of editing. Okay, so have a nice day. And now, for those in my time zone, go to bed for a while. You probably have school. Why are you up? Why am I up? I don't have school. That's one thing, dude. Come on now. Okay, bye guys. Have a nice day. Where's the stop button? Of course, I'll lose the stop button at the last moment. Oh, there it is. Found it. Bye.